We're not exactly sure why, but the dust emissions from the dunes here at Oceano are very high, among the highest I've seen, and I've worked in coastal dune systems around the world. All dune systems emit dust. That's just a normal part of the geology of things at these sites, but there's something in the mineralogy and geologic history here. And part of it is there's a mineral called feldspar that mixes in with the quartz grains that are quite common here. And that feldspar breaks down a little more readily than quartz does. And those fine particles of feldspar get lofted into the air. So when we implement things like a vegetation treatment or a sand fence, we're tripping up the flow to extract some of that force so that it doesn't move down to the grains, doesn't make them hop, bombard, and emit dust. And so for every grain that we trap, we're reducing a certain number of grains of dust that would be emitted by that process. Over time, most surfaces will what we call winnow, and the coarser particles are left behind on the surface and they end up protecting or armoring the surface. And we would then see less saltation and less dust emissions. But with vehicle action, one of the things that happens is there's a lot of mixing, you know, down to about half a foot or even more, depending on the type of vehicle and how fast they're moving, how loose the sand is. So you're constantly bringing those fine particles back up to the surface. And so that's one of the links between vehicle activity and the dust emissions, is that mixing process. And then there's another possible link, that is the physical force of the wheels churning those sand grains and grinding them up and releasing finer particles due to that direct mechanical action. This is not a rooster tail process of vehicles emitting dust themselves. I mean, there's a small amount emitted around vehicles when you rip over a surface, but really the wind is doing most of the emission of the dust here. But there is a link between the vehicle activity and the fine particles that are on the surface. We know that the areas that have been driven on for decades are more emissive than areas that have been protected. And so we don't know the direct link yet, but it relates to one of those two causes that I was talking about earlier, the mixing process and then the direct grinding process.